What do you got at Karen's now? What new things have you come across? Ask about the dust crystals.
The Fallen did manage to make a mother crystal of their own, did they? Fat lot good it did them. Brought the wrath of God down on their own stupid heads and left it to their descendants to clean up the mess they left behind. You did a good job making the sage spires spick and span, but if that fallen heart were anything like the others, I'd wager there's plenty of shards still out there sitting in stockpiles waiting to be sold to the highest bidder. Still, they're not like to last long, shoddy things they are, and anyone who tries to flog them as common crystals is begging to get themselves nabbed for dealing in dodgy goods. Those crystals are nought but curios now?
Curios, like curiosities, or like a curio cabinet, a display item.
They're part of the world's history, not its future.
Coin purse weighing you down?
I wouldn't say that exactly. Is there a way? No, it's just comparing and organizing. What was the new item? Or was it just the ability to kick up some conversation? And belts. Everything else here sucks. Compare by, yeah, value, sun bracers. Channeler's Whispers. Automatically charges magic spells, maintaining. You know, I can afford it. I'm not going to equip it, though. Don't need to buy any meteorites. Iconoclasm orchestral role.
You'll not find a better price than that.
And insufficient inventory space. The fuck does that mean? Or do I already have one of these? I guess I found one throughout the world. Well, that's pretty cool. I like that. Let's get up to 7. Stone skin.
It'd better all be here.
What do I have? That's dad's sword. Not gonna sell that. Don't wanna sell. That's dad's belt. Regal sash. It's not as good as Ouroboros. You can go. Founder's grasp. Alright, that is dad's. Archduke Elwyn. Archduke Elwyn. Founder's Grasp. Brings up health by 50, but drops defense by. Well, gives me a plus 20 and 6. No, those 20 health points aren't going to make that much of a difference. 2700? Sure. I'll sell it. Rings, not going to sell any of my rings, just hoarding those. Used in crafting. Omega nodule.
Finished, are you?
Hey, Blackthorn.
What do I owe the honor?
I got this fucking thing. Can I you... Omega weapon. Fallen Enforcer. I guess I have that. Plus 35. A blasphemous coupling of living flesh and synthetic bone. This relic of an age long forgotten shudders with the selfsame vital spirit that animated the Sage Spire's mightiest of sentinels. And when he looked upon mankind's creation, he saw himself. Yeah.
Lost you a good while.
Yeah, I want that. Plus 35, dude. That's almost too powerful. Why would you make it so powerful? And of course, I can't reinforce it. That would be crazy. Cuckoo fucking wild crazy if I could reinforce that. Thank you. Hey, Gootsie.
Is there all you need?
No new things to talk about. What is... Okay... Check those missives, look at the shelf there, check in with Vivian, and Take a look at the... come on, brain. We can put it together. The jukebox. Clear out anything in there. Talk to Uncle Byron for a moment here. Hey, Uncle.
Alive, my boy.
Nothing. Okay, fine.
That's my boy.
And there wasn't a pip on there, so... It was... high hopes. Let's go through all these. Missing... Only a few, it feels like. Which I'd probably be able to find in the overworld. But there's not a trophy associated with it, so there's no point. Let's get a look at that thing. It looks so evil. I love it. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful sword. Hey. And, oh, yeah, that's how you kick off the Rising Tide DLC. Just want to enjoy my Wall of Memories. The Dusk Shard. A subtle reflection of mankind's fiery yet flawed, brilliant yet brittle, and its future, clear yet clouded. How the crystal endures despite its mother having faded is perhaps a sign of hope for us all. The Oath, the Hangman signboard. Just one missing there, and that comes from Rising Tide. Dear Cid.
Dear Cid, I write you this note from the Imperial Lands. Yes, I know we said we'd be going straight home, but a little detour to trade the trinkets we picked up on our travels from the trusty Gil seemed in order. Give the Elder something to soften their shock of losing the dust crystals like. Truth is... those crystals have long been a lifeline of our people, and though I may have been quick to comprehend your ration reasoning, that they are not but a tether to a sinking ship, humble country folk like mine are rather less receptive of new ideas. Wish me luck in turning them to the righteous path, Famille. P.S. It is unlikely, in the unlikely event, that we should ever find ourselves driven from our home at point of pitchfork. I trust you'll spare us a bed or three. The lads can sleep on the floor in a pinch.
Cute. Very cute. Just want to speak with Vivian, see what breakdown she has of those events, or if there is any new information on that. Might be, might not be. Nothing to speak with old Dion about. Be like, hey Dion, we fought this wild shit, and he's like, that's crazy, you're crazy, fuck off, go away.
What will it be today?
Status of the realm.
I have the details here.
Meeting the Echoes. Characters appearing in Echoes of the Fallen have been added to the grand cast, and the timeline has been updated. Speak with Vivian in the hideaway to learn more. I'm doing just that. So dusk falls. Soon after the dark skies spread across Valisthea, bringing chaos and confusion in their wake, a new type of crystal began to circulate on the black market. Spiritless shards known as dust crystals, and now the very earth beneath Valisthea's feet begins to tremble. Could these strange phenomenon be connected? Three merchants flee from the gates of Port Isidol, unwilling to offer up their packs for inspection, perhaps because the trade in dust crystals that once thrived in the city's docks has recently been outlawed by official decree. They make for the northern borders of the province, where an ancient fallen tower begins to shine with a sinister light. The sage spire walls are now lined with dust crystals, and its halls filled with the fruit of the fallen's godforsaken experiments. Ancient beasts transformed into living weapons, and the heart of a man-made mother crystal. With the destruction of the latter, the dark crystal fade, and the tower falls silent at long last. And situation map? Information on Echoes of the Fallen has been added to the situation map, and the timeline has been updated. Speak with Vivian in the hideaway to learn more. Got it. And connected to Port Isidol, Clive comes to the grim conclusion that there may yet be another mother crystal still standing, leeching ether from the land. Even now, it must be located and destroyed. To this end, Joshua and Jill leave for Port Isidol, where Karen obtained her samples. Clive chases the Dust Crystal traders led by the roguish Famille across the length and breadth of Rosaria, cutting down those bandits and beasts engaged in their own pursuit. Though the traders at last succeed in making their getaway, it is clear to where they are bound, the Sage Spire. The destruction of the man-made heart. Clive discovers the source of the dark dust crystals within the Sage Spire. Through a myriad of fallen abominations, last and most abominable of which being the Iconoclast Omega, stand between him and the artificial heart. He and his ally succeed in cutting it down and putting an end to its ether leeching activities. Cool.
Thus ends today's lesson.
Just in case you forgot what we did for the last 2.5 hours, roughly. Now to kick off the last one. Yeah, I think Echoes of the Fallen, when the DLC was announced, it was rather cheap. I think it was less than $10 for 2.5 hours and some new additional stuff and just the boost in stats from the weapons and armor that I've gotten. Fucking totally worth it. Absolutely. Unmarked. Sid, I shall not waste time mincing words. Leviathan's dominant is in need of rescue, and despite my innumerable misgivings about joining hands with an outlaw of the highest disrepute, the Dame has assured me that there is none better suited to the task at hand. I dare not reveal more for fear this missive could fall into the wrong hands. But if what little I have penned here has kindled your interests, I bid you journey to the Vale of Northreach and inquire with one Lyle? Layla. She will surely see you satisfied. Ooh, another whore. Oh, or maybe information. Help the mysterious request. Sure, why not?
Leviathan the Lost. But why now? After all this time.
Maybe that giant crystal flowing in the sky? Yeah, Joe. Common sense. Leave it to her.
I'm not sure you'd believe me if I told you.
Oh, you don't know exactly what I was talking about.
Through. I doubt there's anything that could surprise me at this point.
We just fought a living tower.
All right, then. Rouse Joshua and meet me in the mess. We'll talk there.
Like in public, in the mess hall? About Leviathan the Lost? Is that a good idea? Wouldn't that stir up worry?
I see we're all here.
This isn't the mess hall at all. This is over by the bounty board.
What is it this time?
Or is the mess hall not nearby the jukebox?
Letter delivered to my chambers omitted a few crucial details.
Do we know its provenance?
That was one of the details it omitted. But whoever the sender was, it seems the Dame held them in high enough regard to point them in our direction.
1 second. Active time... Tides. Entries for the rising tide will now appear in the active time lore. If you don't recognize a term or wish to know more about events currently unfolding, hold the whatever the fuck that button's called to access relevant information. Leviathan the Lost. Despite the prominence of the dominants and their icons in modern politics and warfare, recent history makes no mention of an icon of water. So long has it been, in fact, since Leviathan last appeared in Balthier, that he is now almost exclusively referred to as the Lost. As to where exactly he went, though no one is quite certain. Icon! Just in case you're not sure. Shattered aspects of Ultima's power given flesh by human hosts. It is the two wardens of fire, Phoenix and Ifrit, who together comprise its perfect form, the icons of the lesser element serving as sacrifices to Mythos's altar in order to test and bolster the vessel's strength. Northreach, a town which once acted as a defensive gateway to Sembrake's holy capital of Oriflam, not long after the skies took a turn for the ominous and because of Primogenesis, and most of the old capital was lost to the Aether Flood, the Imperial High Cardinal arrived with designs to build a new empire, but at great cost to the citizens of Northreach. It was at the inn, at this... No, sorry. It was at this time Ultima's thralls, I don't even know where he said the word in. descended upon the fields both north and south of the Great Wall, forcing those citizens to choose between abandoning their town or fighting and possibly dying for those they loved. The people chose the latter, and after a hard-earned victory, the High Cardinal was finally convinced to join hands with Madame Isabel, and a modicum of order was at long last restored. Good old Northreach.
Well, she's no one to waste our time. It must be important.
You sound...
Important might be an understatement.
Like you're not convinced, Otto.
If the letter is to be believed...
You sound doubtful.
Leviathan's dominant is in danger. And someone wants us to save him.
Leviathan?
Leviathan the Lost.
The water has finally returned. What has it been? 100 years?
I don't know. I'm only 30. What do you want from me?
Lost, Monica, dates back at least that long. Even our venerable Dorsman would not have been so much as a glint in his father's eye when last the mighty serpent brought his crushing waves to bear upon the realm.
But why the gap? I know it can be a few years before a new dominant's born. But over a century?
Now, the ones that are born with the power of dominant
have been severed somehow,
are just separated.
Have prevented a new dominant from awakening.
But if one has awakened now, he couldn't have chosen a worse time. Every nation in the realm has lost its dominant. If word gets out that there is still one to be had, they will stop at nothing to claim it for their own.
Dion can still turn into Bahamut.
War again, just when humanity most needs to come together.
And Jill can still channel Shiva. Else.
Only that if I wish to know more, we must meet in person. And that the Vale can arrange a meeting.
Hmm. If nothing else, you can be certain it ain't a trap.
Maybe I'm hoping it's a trap. I do love murder.
I'm coming with you.
As am I.
Thank you. Both of you. And Otto?
Yeah. I'll keep an eye on things here. Didn't fancy coming anyway.
We can leave Goots in charge if you really want to tag along.
Capable hands.
Quest accepted. The Rising Tide. Are we going to get a nice little title splash screen? No, I guess not. Chasing the Tides. Quest destinations for the Rising Tide are indicated with the icon. After accepting the quest, current objectives are displayed in the to-do list on the right-hand side of the screen. These will temporarily replace main scenario objectives. Prioritizing the Tides. If you wish to restore main scenario objectives to the to-do list, you can do so on the Journal tab in the main menu. Well, I don't have any other than go finish the game. Find Layla in Northreach. Wait. Let's speak to Vivian at the beginning of this instead of doing what I did for Echoes of the Fallen. Then being like, hey, you know everything we just did? Well, let's read about that. State
what
of the realm.
You wish to learn?
Let's kick
Here's
this off.
Information I have.
Ba-bing! Meeting the Tides. Characters appearing in the Rising Tide have been added to the grand cast, and the timeline has been updated. Speak with Vivian in the Hideaway to learn more. That's what I'm doing. Lost and found. Every scholar is in agreement that Leviathan, the Warden of the Water, is no more. The Great Serpent having last been sighted well over a century past. The bloodline in which the swarm most likely severed. The bloodline in which it swam. Most likely severed. If, however, it were to become known that its dominant still lived, the race between every faction recently bereaved of their own icon to claim such a weapon, and with it, supremacy, would surely shatter the fragile peace that currently reigns. Situation map. Information on the Rising Tides has been added to the situation map, and the timeline has been updated. Speak with Vivian in the Hideaway to learn more. To Northreach, Clive receives an anonymous letter alleging that the dominant of Leviathan not only lives, but needs his help. After assembling his allies, he makes for the Vale to meet the courtesan who passed the note from its enigmatic author to Isabel.
The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Yes, I'm aware. I've heard that shit before. Nothing else to check out here, lore-wise? Then to Northreach we go.
Ding.
Yes. Thank you for indicating where Northreach is. Gonna have to do a little bit of a tour around, just hitting up all the merchants and shopkeepers I can.
And what can I do for you?
Just to make sure I've bought everything that I can. Like this.
You've a keen eye.
I don't want to equip it, though. Reduces Raging Fist cooldown. I do love Raging Fist. Increases Heaven's Cloud damage.
An excellent choice.
Don't want to put that on, though. Meteorite, don't need any of that. Orchestral Rolls, bought everything I could. Oh, I'm down to 10 grand. Oh boy, I hope that this whole quest line pays out good. Because I'm almost poor again. Spent it all on baubles and orchestral rolls and unnecessary shit. No. If I need money bad enough, I do get more money from doing quests. But if I needed money bad enough, I could put on the one badge. I think it's called a badge. What is it considered? What is it called? What are they called? Accessories. Those ones I just bought. Channeler's Whispers. Yeah, charge magic. Could throw in the accessory that gives me 35% more gil? Layla!
You found one. So, will your friends be joining in? Or just watching?
Chotto matte. One moment. Leviathan the Lost. More information. So long has it been since the Icon of Water last appeared in Valisthea that many have forgotten Leviathan even existed, despite much evidence of the contrary. Old writings clearly speak of Dominant's past summoning great whale-like creatures capable of swallowing entire cities with their gaping maws. Visual records such as the framed circle of Malleus tapestry also exists, depicting the icon as a giant serpent alongside the elemental brethren. Its elemental brethren.
We're not here for your services. We simply want to talk.
Well, that costs money too, you cheap bastard.
The price is still the same.
We hear about the letter.
Oh, yes. Well, I guess you are here for some serious matters, not just hinky-panky.
Oh, sorry. I suppose you'll be wanting to know who wrote it, then.
Or at least who is requesting our assistance.
Look, I'm just the messenger here.
Mm-hmm.
There's only so much I can tell you.
A very... specifically. Ebony-skinned and perky messenger.
North of town, on the shore of Eulafeist Bay.
Eulafeist.
There you'll find a tent. And the woman who can answer your questions.
And that's all.
Is she going to solicit me for sex as well?
Actually, one thing. There's more than flowers in the meadows these days. So keep that sword of yours to hand.
It is a nice sword. Thank you for the warning.
Does anyone else think it's strange that this woman should prefer to keep to the outskirts of town?
Not if she realizes the value of the information she's party to.
And the danger it puts her in.
While we're here, might as well say hello to the dame.
Northreach welcomes you.
Yo, girl!
The last few years
have been anything but kind, Northreach. Yet we've managed to endure in spite of it all, with a little help, of course. And while it's still a shadow of what it was before the fall of Drake's Head, the town has rediscovered something I had half given up for lost.
Hope
that tomorrow might be a better day. You can see it in the eyes of each and every one of us, in our smiles.
Belief that we all matter.
That we can all make a difference. We are not merchants, soldiers, courtesans, or even bearers. We are the people of Northreach, and we are one.
The world around us may be dying, but here in the shadow of this forgotten wall, we found a new life for ourselves. We've put aside past quarrels, put aside our pride, that we might make space in our hearts for more important things, like each other.
And should the skies grow even darker?
We will not fret, for we know we can overcome anything, so as long as we stand together.
Well?
I think it is safe to say we showed the Duke of Knot the error of his ways. The problem with so many leaders of men is that they know little of the men they wish to lead. Having seen firsthand who we are and what it is we fight for, perhaps now he will better understand how to govern us. He is already in talks with the merchants about fortifying the markets and constructing new housing on the far side of the wall, which should certainly endear him to those who, until recently, would cheerfully have tied a noose around his neck.
Why?
He's even made amends with his daughter, Sabine, for as long as one might with a fiery spirit as she. Ugh, fight with that sentence.
Yes.
Despite the Duke's many failings, which are diverse and plenty, mind you, I believe his love for the Empire and his desire to see it endure in these, its darkest of days, are sincere.
And who knows?
In time, we may yet allow him to add Duke of Northreach to his list of titles. Ask about Isabel's new role. As if running the veil weren't enough, it would appear I have been elected the townspeople's representative.
For his part.
The Duke concurred, though it would scarcely have mattered if he hadn't. So unanimous was the clamor. Had he knowing that trying to pit us against each other would only result in our bonds growing stronger, I dare say he might have taken a different approach. He underestimated us, though, to be fair, we underestimated ourselves. Northreach will only ever be as strong as the sum of her people, and it was when we stood united that we stood tallest. We cannot simply rely on a wall to protect us. We must be the wall, and I intend to be, when my role permits, the rising tide.
Forgive me, Clive.
You doubtless have questions, but knowing what you know, I trust you understand why I would not do to speak of such matters here.
Do as Layla told you.
And should your curiosity be left unsatisfied, come and see me again. Well, brief.
Short and sweet, then.
Yeah, very short and sweet, thank you. I thought you'd go on for a couple of paragraphs like you did about a mission I finished 4 hours ago? 3 or 4 hours ago? I suppose I should have come and talked to you once we had finished everything here. Go Phoenix Shift. Get my... Yep, you looked. Now you gotta die. God. Everything just disappears. God damn, I love it. You want some too? Shouldn't have looked. Wrecked his shit hard. Thinking about it, I saw something for ability points there. I'm like, boy, I am sitting on a lot of ability points. Maybe I should spend them upgrading shit for things I'm never gonna use. I can always reset if need be. I believe there might be an achievement for unlocking all this shit. May as well. Although it's some stuff I never used, I probably never will use. Cold Snap. Yeah, never used Cold Snap. Did I... Arms of Darkness. Yeah, that's Bahamut. Odin Dancing Steel. Shit, I don't even think I had played with that to test out and see what it did. Now is not the time to be messing with my layout.